Okay, everyone, sit down and listen. What you just showed is an absolute disgrace. We're now 3-0 down at half time and it doesn't seem like any of you want to play. You have let yourself down and you've let your keeper down on the first goal, and all of you are pissing on what I'm trying to tell you before the match. We now have 45 minutes to go back out there and show that we still deserve to win this game and that you still deserve to play for this team.
Do it 1v1 all day long. I don't care if you lose the ball every single time. I want you to go and do it. Because I trust you both and believe in you both. We need to just lift the tempo a little bit. One and two touch and you will kill them. You'll win this game 3-1, 4-1, 5-1. But by doing what we just talked about. If not, flick of a coin. You need to choose which one. Ready?
Hello and welcome to our Solent University online CPD looking at the coach-created motivational climate. Coaches account for motivation as energising, regulation and persistent behaviour in football. Research into motivational climate was originally conducted in schools, but it was then looked at in sports settings. So, coaches, parents and peers can create sporting interests of players so that they are happy and active participants. Yet, it is the coach that primarily forms this motivational climate within the team. Goal setting within a coach-created climate is a powerful tool to increase motivation. So, outcome goals are linked to ego orientation, whereas performance goals are linked to task orientation. Following on from task orientation is a developed method called target. Target is used by coaches to create a motivational climate within both team and sport settings. First in the target method is the task. Task is the challenges you as the coach give to the players. You as the coach should encourage the task to be learning focused. For youth players, this should be technical skills, tactical movements, or decision making. Moreover, the task needs to be individualized to meet the player's requirement. It is crucial to disregard comparison between players, as this will create rivalries and an ego orientation.
This is at the beginning of the session, and the coach have chosen a ball mastery drill to get all the players warmed up by using the ball. Here, he gives one of the better players a more demanding challenge, since the exercise is too easy for him. It is important to not compare players, as you want them to focus on themselves rather than measure themselves up against their peers. Make sure that the feedback is on the progress of the player and the task.
Next in the target framework is authority. Authority is allowing players to participate in the decision-making process. This could include letting players set their own rules in the game. In other words, authority is whether the player has the autonomy to decide when and how to do the task, which is why you should link authority and task. Beware though, this is a risk when players decide the rules, as this may limit the learning for new skills. For example, you want your players to learn dribbling, playing with a maximum of two touches will prevent this. Therefore, task and authority should be linked.
As we can see here, the coach is now briefing his players on the next practice, which is going to be a game-related one. The coach have also included the players in the decision-making of the game's rules, scoring system, and size of the practice. This will give the players more autonomy.
The R in target is for recognition. Recognition is defined by acknowledging someone's work in a particular task. During your session, it is important that you notice the work done. An effective method of recognising effort is by encouraging your players. Encouraging words like well done and good effort show your appreciation. Taking time to give one-to-one feedback with your youth players will positively affect their intrinsic motivation.
Here, the coach chooses to reward the effort of one of his players for how he's been working towards his goals. By meeting his player like this, the coach lets the player know that he appreciates the works he put in.
The fourth in our target method is grouping. Grouping is how the coach mixes the players to ensure individualised improvement. In youth football, mixing players of different abilities and age will challenge them to work within a different environment. This means that better players can work on lifting lesser players, while the lesser player will learn from the challenge. By extension, testing players in different positions on the field will let them experience different situations, which will improve adaptability.
In this 1v1 session, the coach have chosen to group the better player with two lesser players. This way, the lesser players have to challenge themselves to succeed during the practice. However, the better player get to support the lesser players with how they can improve. It is important that the players learn to cooperate, how to overcome future challenges.
The fifth target is the importance of evaluation. Evaluation focuses on the importance of player and team improvement. When evaluating, it is important to emphasise effort, teamwork and progress. By giving players ownership in their evaluation, you encourage them to participate in their own development, and this improves effort. Highly motivated players strive for feedback from you, the coach, by creating an environment where feedback is wanted rather than feared, and the effort and feeling of accomplishment will flourish.
As we can see, the coach is using a player profile sheet for the players to evaluate their progress. This is a great visual tool for the players to measure their own improvement. Here, you can see an example of a player profile sheet. By using a scoring system from 1 till 10, it's easier to visualize their personal growth.
The final target is timing. Do you dedicate enough of your time to every player during a session? Are you giving your players enough time in a match to shine? It is essential to consider that players learn at different speeds. Some players might need more time to accomplish the same tasks. In other words, are you letting the players work at their own pace? The importance here is about time management. As you will see in the session, time is closely linked to the other targets.
Timing is a point that can be seen in all the other points in target. During the practical, it's been really important that a coach has had the right timing for when to give feedback. For example, you as a coach need to make sure to provide feedback as quickly as possible after the player performs a task.
Thank you for coming to today's CPD. I hope that there's lots you can take away from this session.